Hey guys and girls, welcome back to another adventure in Forza Horizon 3. Now we're just on our way to go and do one of these, you know, underground street races again. This one's a little bit harder than any of the others I've done before. Main reason being is because we're going up against a Lamborghini. I think it's a Murcielago SV or something like that. And the reason why I'm bringing the Centanario is because if I'm going to be versing a, you know, a really high-strung Lambo, I think this is my best option. You know, high-strung Lambo versus high-strung Lambo. As I said, I think it's going to be my best option. I don't know what the course is like, as always with these things. You just basically get thrown in the deep end and, you know, hopefully you can beat the other dude and keep his car. So there you go, we're going up against a Lamborghini Murcielago LP670-4 SV. This should be quite interesting. As I said, high-strung Lambo versus high-strung Lambo. My palms are sweaty because I'm nervous. I don't know how this is going to go. And because I'm recording it live, things could go bad and I won't have any control over it. So let's see how we go. Let's get this... Oh, great, it's raining. That means he's going to slip, I'm going to slip, we're probably all going to end up crashing together. Let's do this. I don't think that's stock. Oh, wow. He's ripped the Centanario off the line. This is going badly so far. Get him under brakes. I mean, the AI cars aren't known for their all-out speed. Ah! No! Rewind, come on. Come on, I flew off the track there, that's not fair. Okay, let's take it from here. Alright, brakes. Feed the power on gently. Wow, we lost grip in a dip. My only theory is he's going to lose just as much grip as I am through the corners. So my only... I mean, you saw the speed that thing had off the line. If it comes to straight line speed, he's going to whoop my butt. Yeah, he's packing some serious mods under that bonnet. Or that... I don't know, do you call it a bonnet? Or do you call it a hood? Or do you call it an engine cover? What do you call that thing fitted to them Murcielagos? Is it just an engine cover? Oh, come on, Centanario. Come on. Get grip and go. If there's straight sections, he's going to eat us. Maybe the Centanario wasn't the best choice. Yeah, maybe I should have chosen another Hyper Lambo, but I just didn't know what I was going to be facing. I know in these street drags they often bring out some really high-strung cars. As you remember the last one with the RX-7, there was like a point separating us. We need to go. We need to move. We need to go. Come on, Centanario. Let's go. Don't hit anything and don't crash. Checkpoint. It's a straight run. He could overtake us. I don't know. If I hit anything, we're screwed. He's going to be up my clacker in a minute. Yes! Cross the line. How many seconds, though? Not by a hell of a lot. 1 second separated us. Right. Okay. Let's see what Warren has to say about this one. I was a 998, he's a 995, so, yeah, I don't think that thing was stock. Alright, let's see what Warren has to say. Okay.
Space shuttle. Bet it can move though. If you want to take it for a spin, you know where I am.
Alrighty, guys and girls. That one looks like it's a wide body Lamborghini SV. So that's pretty cool. But as you guys know, I love my Lambos. So chances are I've already got one. We'll go back to the Forza nearest Forza Horizon Center. We'll have a look at it. So we're in the outback, so we'll go to here. Although, no, that's closer. We'll go to there. Let's set it for there. Yes, I can fast travel anywhere now that I've gotten all the boards, but where's the fun in that? Now this Centanario is twin turbo. I've done a couple of mods on it. I didn't want to make it a full X99 car because I wanted to keep it in the S2 class but have it up at the top. So that's why it's a 998, not a 999. So pretty cool. Keeps it in the S2 class but right at the top, which is good. So yeah, it's not stock. And boy, is it wet.
In 100 meters, keep right. In 100 meters.
I've had a couple of people ask me, why don't you do the Forzathon ones? Forzathon ones are really cool. The main reason why I'm doing I don't do the Forzathon events is because I'm usually too wrapped up doing them, and I kind of get a little bit excited. I have to admit, sometimes I do let rip with a potty mouth word, and it doesn't make for good viewing seeing me struggle in a game. It really doesn't. I don't mean struggle as in naturally bad driving. I mean as in me having to restart an event over and over again because I don't actually succeed. So that's the reason why I don't cover the Forzathon events. But there are other channels that do cater for the Forzathons. However, you will see in the very near future, if I'm successful at one of the Forzathon events coming up, which is a one-day event, which means the VIPs get to, have at it and try and win a championship in order to get a Lamborghini Sesto Elemento, and I am definitely going to be down for that one. I've actually cancelled a whole weekend of going out and partying just for this event. So you guys will be able to tell whether I'm successful or not at getting the Sesto Elemento, because I'll either own one or I won't. Simple as that. But let's go have a look at this Lambo, and we'll see what it looks like. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Everyone knows the alphabet except me. Okay, Lamborghini. Here we go. What do we got? Okay, so I do have a couple of... I do have a Lamborghini... Murcielago SV LP670 whatever. There it is with the wide body kit installed, and that's what it looks like when you win the one from the tournament. Okay, so I already have one, so I'm gonna put this one up on the auction house, and you guys can watch me do that right now. Auction house, start auction, go and find the car I want. And someone is going to get a pretty good deal on one of these. Because I'm going to list it relatively inexpensive. This one. So just make sure that I do have two. That's the new one, and that's the one I think I modified. I'm going to sell... Oh, I don't know. I can't make up my mind. The one with the aero will probably get us more money, but the one without aero is the one we just won. Decisions. I think I'm going to get rid of that one. Auction the car, yep. Now, I'm going to jack things up a little bit because I want a bit more cash for this thing. Jack the buyout price to 300,000, list it for 3 hours, and hit confirm. Now, brand new, they're worth 500,000, but as I was going to say in a video a couple of days ago, I'm sick and tired of seeing cars on the auction house that are way above the recommended retail. There's no point putting a car on the auction house and expecting it to sell if you list it for more than what it costs to get it at the auction house. I mean, I'm one of these people where I don't care how much money you put into a car, right? Like, I don't care how much money. I know that it costs only $100,000 to fully deck out a car. So if you put this vehicle stock as is on the auction house at $500,000, I'm not going to buy it. Because I know I can go to the auto show and buy one brand new for $500,000, spend $100,000, and get a better deal. But if you listed a fully modded one on the workshop for $500,000, I'd probably snap it up pretty quick, because I know full well how much one of them things cost to modify. But let's just roll with this. If we go to search the auction house, right? Now, a couple of weeks ago, I got a Porsche 911 Turbo S for $400,000. The dude who listed it was either he didn't know the value of the car or he was being a really awesome dude and listed it for $400,000. If we go and have a look today for a Porsche 911 Turbo S 2014 edition, all right, some people have got rocks in their head. They're listing them at $4, $5, $6 million. They're not worth it. Brand new, they only cost like 180. Look at this, 4 million. And only a couple of weeks ago, I picked one up for 400,000. So, you know, and look, I'm gonna show you, I'm not pulling your leg. You know, I'm not pulling your leg. But here we go. I don't care how rare a car is, $4 million for a car, I'm going to look at you and go, you're an idiot. You know, if you list one up there for $400,000, I'm going to think you're a legend. But look, here we go, just to prove I'm not yanking your crank. $150,000 brand new. Now, I paid $400,000 and I thought that was a bit steep. But compared to $4 million, I got an absolute bargain. Anyway, guys and girls, I'm going to call this video here. Thanks for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit the little alarm bell thing so you guys can keep up with the Forza action. I am working on getting a Discord channel set up so you guys will be able to join me on adventures and challenges when we do them. I am working on that. Just give me a chance. The other thing is, guys and girls, is I'm going to try and, you know, as I said, try and do a couple of one-on-one with people, like meet the members and give you guys a bit of screen time. So if I basically do a one-on-one with you, I basically see how you drive, see if you've got the personality necessary for a bit of online exposure. I shouldn't say exposure, but a bit of online presence. And if you've got the right attitude, then you'll be featured in a video, no problems at all. Okay, so I am working on that. There will be a bit of one-on-one where I'll challenge you to a race and you might beat me. That'd be awesome, because I'm not a very good driver, as you guys have seen. But I am going to try and get something sorted out like that in the very near future. Alrighty, guys and girls, thanks for watching. As I said, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe down below if you've got any other challenges you'd like me to take on or any cars you want me to review. Remember, try and keep them under $1 million, because I'm not made of money. All right, until next time, guys and girls, I'll say bye for now.